The role of microbiome in the allergic disease of children is more and more recognized. Some years ago, we simply did not have any idea of the importance of this part of our organism. But today, we increasingly are aware of the importance of microbiome in the development of immunity, and in particular of innate immunity. For this reason, that has been explained in other presentations, we are now attempting to use the microbiome modulation to treat or prevent allergic disease. Regarding treatment, we have some studies in allergic rhinitis, in allergic asthma, in atopic dermatitis and in food allergy, but the results are inconsistent. The meta-analysis on these aspects, treatment by probiotics or prebiotics of this disease, conclude that there is still not enough evidence for suggesting them at the practical level. Of course, new studies will individuate better probiotics in order to get the results we are dreaming about. And it's possible that in the future we will have effective treatment based on probiotics. But this future is not an incoming future. Regarding prevention, the situation is different. A lot of literature has been produced since 2001, so in the last 15 years, suggesting that some aspects of microbiota modulation can be of help to reduce the risk of allergic disease in children. We are speaking about dietetic interventions, but also supplemental interventions, in particular supplements as probiotics, specific probiotics or prebiotic fibers, have been studied in a series of studies. In 2015, the Journal of Allergy and Clinical Immunology published a meta-analysis in which 28 studies on probiotics were reviewed in order to assess the effect of this class of treatment in the prevention of atopic disease in children when administered in pregnancy, during breastfeeding, or directly to infants. The results of the meta-analysis is that, first, it's impossible to find a specific probiotic because no one has the sufficient evidence to be declared allergy preventive. Second, that the class taken together has some effects. These effects are evident in the prevention of atopic dermatitis. To be precise, the use of probiotics in pregnancy can reduce atopic dermatitis by 10% in children. When the mother breastfeeding will take probiotics, this will result in a reduction of 15% of atopic dermatitis in children. And the direct administration of probiotics to children translates in a reduction of atopic dermatitis of 5%. No meta-analysis was able to show that there are any effect of probiotics on allergic rhinitis, asthma, and food allergy. But atopic dermatitis is the initial step of the allergic march. These results informed a wide discussion in the scientific community and informed a guideline. Following this meta-analysis, the great working group in McMaster University, together with the World Allergy Organization that organized the guideline, published a guideline in 2015 suggesting that taking probiotics during pregnancy, during breastfeeding, and in infancy can be considered a possible strategy for the prevention of allergic disease. Regarding prebiotics, the situation is more simple because we don't have studies of prebiotics in pregnancy nor in breastfeeding. In infancy, however, the published studies point the fact that prebiotics are very effective in the prevention not only of atopic dermatitis, but also of rhinitis and asthma. Thus, the guideline on prebiotics, the name is GLAD-P, Prebiotics, published in 2016, indicates the use of prebiotics as a useful tool for the prevention of such diseases, not only in at-risk children, but also in the general population. These guidelines, in practice, change the scenario of allergy prevention that was, for the moment, since now, that was devoted only to the reduction of antigen exposure. Now we have new weapons for the prevention of allergy. Of course, we still are not very effective, but they can be used in a combined strategy.